Hi, my name is Elena Carletti. I am a professor of finance at Bocconi University. And today what I would like to talk to you about is the debate on non-performing loans, their importance, and in particular, why banks prepare with them with the accumulation of reserves. So to understand the problem of non-performing loan, let me start from a little bit more behind. Let me discuss with you why banks are so hit by crises in general. We have seen in the last four crises: the global financial crisis, the euro area crisis, the COVID crisis, and now recently the Ukraine invasion by Russia. And in all these cases, although these crises have been very different, in all these cases, the sector that has been most affected has been the banking sector. It's enough to look at the stock prices of banks at the outset of the COVID pandemic. It was clearly an exogenous shock. Banks had nothing to do with that. But if you look at their stock prices, they plummeted much more than any other sector in the economy. What this suggests is that banks play a crucial role in the financing of the economy. They are the chain between saving and investment still today. And therefore, every time something happens to the economy broadly defined, they are affected massively. And every time there is a debate, a crisis, there is a new debate coming up about what kind of risk banks are facing, how is their solvency position, what is their liquidity position, and how they get prepared for the crisis and the unfolding of it. And in Europe, given that they play such an important role in the financing of corporates, one of the debates that is again and again coming to the table is the debate on non-performing loans. What are they? They are loans that banks give to borrowers that may not be paid back. And why are they important? Let me just give you an example. A bank has given a loan of 100 to a corporation A. This corporation is in trouble and is able to repay only 50 back to the bank. At that point, the bank should recognize that the loan in the balance sheet is no longer valued 100, but is rather valued 50. And the 50 that remained would become a loss for the bank and would affect their capital level. So given this, banks normally have an incentive not to recognize the losses coming from non-performing loans because they don't want to have their capital level affected. So what should banks do in conjunction with this issue? They should do mostly two things. One is to try and recover from the borrower as much as possible. Therefore, go and intervene and go and try to restructure or sell the loan or do whatever is needed to try and recover the maximum value. But the second, which is the core of what I want to talk to you today, is they should start accumulating provision, which means if they understand that the borrower may be unable to pay, they should start accumulating provision in anticipation of future losses. And this is called coverage ratio. Therefore, how much reserves, how much provision the banks have accumulated over time against potential losses on their loans, so against the creation of non-performing loans. This is a more and more important tool of policy, the coverage ratio, because you can understand that the more provision the bank have, the more is prepared against future losses. However, if you look at how many reserves banks have and the coverage ratio across Europe, you see an important situation. You see that banks differ massively in their coverage ratio, not only across countries, but also across banks within the same country. So with some colleagues, we wrote a paper, I call it the Five Ladies because we have five female co-authors, and we wrote a paper on what are the drivers of coverage ratios for banks. We have a big data set, more than 400 banks, European, from many European countries. We are looking at the period 2010-2017, and we are asking the question, what drives the decision of banks to provision against future losses on loans? And therefore, what is the variation in coverage ratio? What drives it? We focus on two different types of drivers: the microeconomic drivers and the macroeconomic drivers. Macroeconomic drivers are everything that is bank-specific. Macroeconomic drivers is what is country-specific. What do we find? We find the three main results. The first one, we find that micro factors, so bank-specific characteristics like credit growth or the amount of NPL or forward-looking indicators of credit risk, are the most important determinants for coverage ratio. In terms of the macro effect, instead, the macro variable, what we find is that banks in countries where, for example, there is more macroprudential policies like dynamic loan loss provision, or where there is a more developed secondary market for loan sales, in those countries, ceteris paribus, banks will have higher coverage ratios than in countries where this is not the case. Similarly, in countries where the rule of law is better and therefore also insolvency procedures are better, we find that banks have higher coverage ratios than in countries where this is not the case. So this is important. Why is important? It's important because this suggests that if we want to use coverage ratio as policy tools, we should focus more on bank-specific factors like on country characteristics. And here comes that in terms of policies, what is more important is to look at micro-supervision rather than macro. And this is even more the case because another factor that we consider is that many of the results are left unexplained, meaning that there are, in the analysis, a big component of unobservable characteristics that explain the coverage ratio. What does it mean in more generic terms? It means that what's really important for the coverage ratio of banks are, yes, rules, both micro and macro, but micro more, as I was saying, but what's really important is the supervisory dialogue, so that banks and supervisor talk to each other, they communicate and they do it daily, if not more times a day, but that there is a dialogue that somehow makes sure that banks are preparing themselves for the creation of the non-performing loans. This is important even more today, where we have again a situation of huge uncertainty with the Ukraine invasion by Russia. We know the spillover effect of banks, we don't know the secondary effect, we don't know what may happen, and therefore it's important that banks start getting prepared, accumulating provisions, and the supervisor follow banks in this procedure.